Hey, Redemption Church family, this is Adam coming to you once again live from my front porch. Hey, as we've been watching the news and just everything going on in the world, I know that we have a lot that we're thinking about, a lot on our hearts and our minds today, and I just wanted to share a couple things with you. The first is I've been really looking at Psalm 23 this week. There's just some things that have been jumping off of the pages onto scripture and to my own life that I wanted to share with you, hopefully as an encouragement and a comfort to you. David writes Psalm 23, he says, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lay down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in paths of righteousness for his namesake. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you're with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil and my cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever." You know, one of the things I was thinking about is that the Lord is our shepherd. In fact, even this Sunday, we're going to be looking at Jesus, who calls himself the Good Shepherd. And the reality is that Jesus knows his sheep. He loves his sheep. In fact, the job of a shepherd is to care for the sheep, to love the sheep, to provide for the sheep, to protect the sheep from danger, and even to lead the sheep to pasture. I think that's a lot of what David is talking about, that because the Lord is our shepherd, because he leads us, because he's with us, because he cares for us, because he protects us and leads us to pasture, places of nourishment and rest that are good for us, that we don't have to be afraid, that even now in the midst of the coronavirus and the governor coming out and saying, 10 or less and stay home unless you have to go to the store, none of that changes the fact that God is still our shepherd who loves us and cares for us and protects us and wants to lead us out to pasture, a place of goodness, rest, and nourishment. In fact, one of the words that sticks out to me here is actually in verse 2 where it says, "He makes me lay down in green pastures." That makes me is a forceful word, that sometimes the Lord leads us to places we don't want to go. Sometimes he leads us into things that we would not choose for ourselves. And as I was thinking about that this week in our context for our lives, is that I would encourage you to embrace what's going on in your life right now. For some of you, that means you're in a forced time of rest. You're in a time where life has slowed down. It's not business as usual. I know for all my introvert friends out there, this is your moment. You've been preparing for this. You are stoked and ready to go. But I also know for some of you, you're worried about what your job looks like in the future. And I know others of you are worried that your boss is going to make you come into work even when people are super sick and coughing and hacking up their lungs. And here's what I'd say. The Lord is your shepherd. He knows and he cares for you and he's with you, and it very well may be that he's leading you into a season. And so I think if you're home with your families, man, use that time to invest in your kids. Use that time to have some fun together. Maybe do something you never do. Maybe sleep in one morning because you can. Take this time to maybe finish a home project. But I think it's an opportunity for us to ask the Lord this question. Hey, Jesus, what are you speaking into my life today? And hey, Jesus, what's your will for my life today? And then whatever that is, as you pray through that and confirm that in scripture, just do that. That you would hear from him and be on mission, living for his glory in your life today. I know for me, we've been spending all kinds of time figuring out what the next couple weeks looks like for Redemption Church. And we're committed to staying connected with you. We want to love you and care for you the best that we can. We want to encourage you. We want to help you continue to take steps of faith on your spiritual journey as you follow after Jesus. And so while we can't physically meet tomorrow, we are going to broadcast, live stream our services online. And I want to give you a couple ideas tomorrow. We're going to be on both Facebook and YouTube, and we'll put those links below. And One of the things you can do is interact. In fact, I'm going to teach kind of different this Sunday, and I'm going to ask for a lot of interaction. And so if you hop on Facebook, you can communicate with us and share some thoughts, answer some questions. And so pull that up on your phone or your computer. Some of you may even be able to pull it up on your smart TV. And we want to interact. We want to stay connected. So you won't just be watching me teach this Sunday. I actually need your help to get the job done. And so we'd love to see you at 9:30 online. We also released a study guide that'll be on our website. It'll help you. It'll have some fill in some blanks. You'll have all the scriptures. You'll be able to take notes. And what I would encourage you to do this week is maybe contact somebody who is a part of our church and share what God is speaking to you. Maybe if God leads you somewhere in the scripture, maybe if he reveals something to you this Sunday, share that with somebody else. Encourage somebody. Invest in somebody. Check in on somebody to make sure they're doing okay. And hey, parents, we know that you're looking for stuff to do, and we want to encourage you to shepherd your families during this time. So if you go to redemption.cc, there's a button we added to our webpage right on the main page. It says resources for kids. So you can have the video that we'll play, that we would play this Sunday in Redemption Kids. It has discussion questions that you can talk about with your kids. It actually has the challenge sheet that we hand out every week, so your kids can continue to do that. And when we finally get back together, have your kids bring those, and we'll have some sort of reward for them like we usually do. And so in many ways, we're going to stay just as connected as we always have. We just can't get together on Sunday. For many of you, I've been making phone calls this week, emails, tweets. We've been doing some Zoom prayer calls, and we're going to continue to do that stuff. And here's the deal. We know that over the next couple weeks, there's going to be some needs in our church body that arise. And I want you to know that we're committed to finding out how we can meet those needs. So if you need anything, maybe you just need a ride to the grocery store. Maybe you're nervous about going to the grocery store. I will act as your personal bodyguard and walk you through the grocery store. Just look really mean. I can do that for you. If you need something, if there's a concern that you have, please feel free to reach out to us. We'd love to pray with you. We'd love to walk alongside you and encourage you to continue to take steps of faith on your spiritual journey. Listen, we love you. We're pumped to try something new tomorrow. It's an experiment. It could go really well. It could fail. Either way, we're going to try it, and we're going to continue to move forward in faith because we still believe Jesus has the whole world in his hands. We love you. Have a great day. We look forward to seeing you tomorrow.